Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about the best baits for March bass fishing. March is finally the first month of the year usually that I get to fish out here in Pennsylvania. I'll get my boat out early March and start fishing away. And oftentimes the fishing can be very good. I catch a lot of fish throughout March, specifically towards the end of the month, but I'll watch the weather, pay attention. When you get a very warm, sunny day, I'll get right out on the water and I'll start actually largemouth fishing instead of smallmouth fishing. And all of the baits today are going to be geared towards that. When you get those warm, sunny days, what'll happen is those largemouth get really active and they'll push up and either get in some grass so that that black, dark grass that absorbs the heat, it'll be the warmest spot in the lake and they'll be very active and everything will be in there. Or if you're fishing a lake that has rocks and wood, any of that dark object, rock, wood, stuff like that, will absorb the heat and those fish will get up there and feed as well. You'll get a couple days of them feeding and then they'll shut down again when it gets cold, and then you'll wait till the next warm front sunny day and they'll get back up there again. Oftentimes you're going to catch some of the biggest bass of the year this time of year. You might not catch a lot, but if you set the hook more often than not, it's going to be a big one. Unfortunately, as I mentioned in the February baits video, I'm not going to be fishing right now. I won't be fishing for the entire month of March. And if you notice, some of these videos have been batch filmed. That's because with my new job, I'll have to do some traveling, which includes to Southeast Asia and visiting some countries over there. So I am gone. This video, when it's posted, I'm actually already gone and I'll be over there, but I'm gone the entire month of March. I won't be able to do any fishing, but I didn't want to leave you guys hanging with videos when March and April are some of the hottest times of year to fish up here in Pennsylvania. So I wanted to give you all my how-to videos on catching fish in March and April so you can utilize these tips while you're out there fishing. And then once I get back at the end of March, I'll be getting my boat out and we'll be getting to fishing and doing a lot of how-to on the water videos the rest of the year. So it'll be very exciting, but right now I had to batch film a bunch of stuff so you guys had some videos to watch while I'm away. Hopefully we'll also be getting a new boat. I'm working on that. If anybody's interested in purchasing my boat, it is for sale, or at least it was when I filmed this video. If somebody had purchased it by then already, that would be great, but it will still be for sale if it's for sale. And if anybody's interested in purchasing my boat, I'm looking to downsize right now and get to a little bit smaller boat to fit in a garage and do some stuff like that. So that might be coming as well. But for now, we'll have a ton of on the water stuff coming in April and beyond. Number one bait for March bass fishing. I caught so many fish on this last year. I have just some examples of it. I don't even have the same crankbait right now because I churned through so many of them. I lost them to logs, broke them, fish, all that kind of stuff. And that's the Sixth Sense Finesse Flat F4 crankbait. I absolutely loved this thing last year. It just came out last year when I started fishing in March. So I got my hands on like two or three of them and I used them and caught a million fish on them. These are example baits right here. So these are Finesse Flat F4s. But not the color that I would fish this time of year. This one maybe. A lot of times in March you're gonna have runoff water into the lake and it's gonna dirty up the water a lot. So I will almost exclusively fish some type of red color. Red and black combo gives you the best contrast and it will catch you the most amount of fish in March. If you have really clear water, I still will use just a flat-sided crankbait in general. So I'll use like a shad pattern. They have chartreuse patterns. They have all kinds of stuff. But my favorite color is actually boiled crawfish. I caught a ton of fish on that last year, caught numerous fish between 3 to 6 pounds on that thing. It was just an amazing March and April of fishing with that bait, pounding it off of laydowns and rocks up shallow and catching some big bass that were moved up there on sunny days, trying to get warm and then also eating a crankbait while they were up there. So this is a great one that I fished with last year. Now, if you have a lake that's more of a grass fishery, a lot of times I go to ponds early in the year, stuff like that, where there's more grass, more open water casting, but you're fishing like submerged grass flats, that stuff still heats up too. So if that water is only 4 foot deep and it has that dark patches of grass in there, that heats up much, much faster than an 8 foot deep basin of water with nothing for them to hold on. So they'll get up there on those grass flats on sunny days too, because that water heats up a lot. A lot of the ponds that I actually go fish, I'll look for ponds that have that dark black bottom, like that mud, gross bottom. You think there would never be any fish in there. There's fish in those ponds. Just they bite really, really well in March and April because that black bottom absorbs a ton of heat and they get more active faster than any other bass or any other lake. So if I'm fishing lakes like that, that's when I'm gonna go with a lipless crankbait. Some of my best days of fishing have come fishing a lipless crankbait in ponds, just ripping it across the top of grass in the middle of February, March, cold days, but it was just sunny one or two days before and warmed that place up, and they'll go ahead and bite like crazy. Again, if you have clear water, bait fish, stuff like that, you can fish a chrome color like this guy here. Something chrome, something shad pattern. It will work good, but again, I'm gonna go with red colors like this guy right here. Anything red and black contrasting is like what I'm gonna throw this time of year. If I'm throwing a hard bait, red and black contrast, and I'm gonna throw it and catch a bunch of fish on it. It's a bite that only lasts a little bit throughout the spring, so I really like to take advantage of it and throw it as much as I can. So this bait right here is the Sixth Sense Duke lipless crankbait. It is very thin and it has a very tight wobble. So why I throw this guy is flat-sided crankbaits work really good in cold water. They don't put off a lot of vibration. They're very tight wiggle, everything like that. But you can't fish that bait in a bunch of submerged grass. So that's where this guy comes into play. This is literally a flat-sided crankbait without a bill. It has a very tight wiggle, not a lot of vibration, and can get you a lot of bites fishing in grass fisheries when you use a lipless crankbait. So that's when I'll pull that one out. Grass versus wood, that's my crankbait choice. And then the last bait that I like to fish, I had, which would have been one of my best days of fishing in Pennsylvania in a long time. I ran out of time fishing last March doing this. I was flipping a jig to those laydowns when that water got sunny, warm, beating down on those logs. I was flipping this jig right here. This is the Sixth Sense Hybrid Jig with a Bongo trailer. This is like a green pumpkin, black and blue combo, or I'll go very dark black and blue or black and purple, dependent upon the water clarity. I was using a 1/2 ounce. If you have dirty water, I'll use the black. If you have clean water, I'll use the green pumpkin. And it was that 1/2 ounce would get down there, and what I would do is literally drag it as slow as I could through every limb on that lay down and make it fish very slowly and look like a small little bluegill working its way through the lay downs. The lake I was fishing, their main forage is bluegill. That's all they look to go after in that lake. And I would thought if they'll eat the crankbait, why wouldn't they eat the jig? It's just slower in those places and has that bluegill profile. I ended up catching 3 fish over 5 pounds in one day on this bait right here. And if I had more time, I guarantee I probably could have caught a couple more that went that size as well. It would have been one of my best spring days of fishing ever up here in the Northeast. It's something that I really like to do every single year. Get out there, drag that jig slow. I fish all the lakes around here like that. As soon as that sun starts to come out, that water gets slightly warmer. It could be 45, 48 degrees. It doesn't seem like a lot. But when it gets to that temperature and you have that sun beating down on the bank, when you're going out there and you're standing out there in rain gear and sweatpants and you're wearing all black clothing and you're like, wow, that sun feels good on my back. That's exactly what those fish are feeling down there in the water when that sun is beaming down on the bank that they're sitting on. So that's when I'll break out this jig and drag it around as slow as I can down there, keeping it in front of those fish. I do not hop this thing around. I don't flip it and pitch it, let it fall to the bottom, bring it back in. I pitch it all the way to the base of a laydown and drag it all the way back out as slow as I can. It's very slow fishing, but if you fish it properly, you'll catch a lot of big fish fishing a jig and a big jig at that early in the spring. So if you're interested in getting any of the Sixth Sense baits and supporting the channel, you can use my code Quince at checkout. You'll save 10% off your entire order and you'll be helping me out to continue making a bunch of awesome videos for you guys. And if you're interested in seeing the February baits video, go ahead and check that one out right there. Hit the subscribe button down below and thanks for watching.